Hi, this is Paul Masetta with TheInfluentialMind.com. And in this video, I want to talk to you about a hypnotic language pattern, specifically the redefine pattern. Now, a lot of times when I talk to people about hypnotic language patterns, they are either A, extremely intrigued by it and they want to know more about it, or they think it's complete nonsense and that it doesn't work. But the reality is, the reason why hypnotic language patterns work, and specifically why the redefine pattern works, is because all you're simply doing is using words to redirect someone's thoughts. You're basically taking them from one trance, you're breaking one trance that they're in, and you're essentially bringing them into another trance. Now, a lot of times when people hear the word trance, they assume that that means that someone's walking around in a zombie-like state. And that's not the truth. The truth is that we are all in trances all of the time. Every single day, every single hour of each day, we are in a trance. The only thing that differs is the level of trance that we are in. So for example, if you drive to work and you drive the same way every single day, I want you to think about what you were thinking about when you drove to work today. You probably can't remember. The reason why is because you were in a trance when you drove to work. You were in deep in thought, but thinking about something that you don't even remember. Same thing happens if you get engaged in a good book or a good movie. The level of trance just simply is deeper when you're engaged in those types of activities. So, what the redefined pattern does is it takes someone who's in one state of trance and it brings them into another state of trance. Now, what kind of situations is something like this going to be valuable in? Well, you could use it when you're debating with someone about a specific topic and they're pretty much being a stubborn person. They don't want to change their point of view. They think that they're right and they're going to sit there and argue with you all day long about a specific topic. You could also use it in a sales environment when you need to overcome an objection from a potential customer that's being very resistant. You could also use it when you're training people, when you're showing people how to do certain things and they're distracted and you want to take them from that state of being distracted from whatever it is that they're thinking about and put them where you want them to be. You could also use it in the dating setting, when you basically want to attract someone to you by redirecting their frame of mind to something that is ultimately going to find you more attractive. So you want to bring them from one thought environment into another thought environment where they're essentially going to perceive you as being more attractive. The redefined pattern is really simple. It works like this. The issue here is not A, it's B, and that means C. You basically are inserting the specific topics of your conversation in those three areas. So what you're really doing is you're basically connecting an existing issue with a redefined statement, and then you are enforcing it with the third statement that you make. So let me explain to you what I mean by this. Let's say you are in the business of selling software and you're pitching a project manager about this new software that you have that could potentially take their business to the next level. But they're a very old school person. They're very ingrained in their ways. They don't like technology. They don't like using email. They don't like text messages. And so trying to talk to somebody like that about software is kind of a dead end street. They don't want to hear about it. They think that software is a waste of time. They think it causes more problems than it actually does good. So what you would say to someone like that is this. The real issue here is not the problems going on in your current project, but how much support you can give your employees. How much better do you think this project would go if they were using the latest up-to-date software that made their jobs easier? So basically what you do is you take the existing issue, you connect it to the redefined statement, and then you support or enforce the redefined statement with the next statement. You could also use this in a job interview. Let's say the person interviewing you is asking you if you had ever been in a similar position to the one that you're applying to and you never had been before. You could say something like this. The real issue here is not whether or not I've worked in this position before, but how dedicated I'll be to getting the best results possible, how much better and more profitable do you think your company would be with someone like me on board who's committed to getting those type of results? Do you see how the redefined pattern works? It basically takes an existing issue, replaces it with a new pattern, and then reinforces it with the next pattern. Now, the thing about hypnotic language patterns is that they work sometimes, they don't work all the time, just like anything else in life. This isn't magic. It's not like you're gonna cast a spell on someone and every single time they're gonna do what you want them to do. What it really all depends on is the level of rapport that you have with this person and the level of trust that they have for you. Because the reality is, if you don't have trust and you don't have rapport, then they're not gonna listen to you anyway, and you're not gonna be in a position to utilize a redefined pattern or any other hypnotic language pattern for that matter. So the first thing that you gotta do is you gotta develop some level of rapport with this person. The second thing that you have to do is you have to be aware of extreme shifts. So the two things that you want to connect in the redefined pattern, they have to be relatable, or they have to be related on one level or another. So you can't say something like, you know, the issue here is not whether or not I'm qualified for this job, but whether or not you want to go out on a date with me tonight. Do you see that? That's going to be a problem if you try to utilize a redefined pattern in that way. All you want to do is take an existing issue, connect it to a new issue or a new pattern that is related to the initial one, and then reinforce it with the third one. If you want to know more about hypnotic language patterns and how they work, check out hypnolanguage.com right now.